Now, it's not very practical to write down every running time function exactly. So computer scientists use various levels of approximation. For complexity, we use asymptotic analysis. I'm going to do a very brief review here, but if you haven't seen this idea before, you should take a few minutes to study it on your own before proceeding with the lesson.
We define big O of a function f to be the set of functions g, where there are numbers c and big N, such that for all little n at least as big as big N, g of n is at most c times f of n. In other words, c times f of n is at least g of n for all sufficiently large n. Even though we've defined big O as a set, we write g of n equals O of f of n instead of using the inclusion sign. We also say that g is order f. This definition can be a little confusing, but it should feel like the definition of a limit from your calculus class. In fact, we can restate this condition to say that the ratio of g over f converges to a constant under the lim soup. An example also helps. Take this function g of n is equal to n squared minus n plus 10. We can argue that this is order n squared by choosing c is equal to 1 and big N equal to 10. For every little n greater than 10, n squared, this red line here, is bigger than the function g, the blue line. We also could have chosen c equal to 10 and big N equal to 1. Again, in that case, the red line, the c times n squared, is bigger than the function g, the blue line. Note that the big O notation does not have to create a tight bound. Thus, g of n is also order n squared. Setting c equal to 1 and n equal to 3 works for this.